In the previous class, I think yesterday, we have discussed about the concept of a class as per the Plato, where we have seen that he has framed three class of citizens, isn't it? So first class was by virtue of wisdom, and they were at a upper hierarchy in the society, and they were the rulers. They were entitled to make the rules, and they, better to say that, they were the part of a governance. Second was by virtue of a carriage, and they were the part of a military system and the defense. And the third was by the virtue of a moderation. They were at the lowest hierarchy in the society. And he had suggested the education as per the class also. So how the education should be. So now in this class, we will further discuss about the educational thoughts of the and the educational philosophy of the Plato. When we talk about the education as per the Plato, means how he was conceptualizing the education. The Plato was in opinion that children must enter in the school at the age of six years. By the age of 6 years, they must enter at the school and they must be engaged in learning the three R's, which is also nowadays emphasized, which is a very beginning of the schooling process, that is the reading, writing and arithmetic. So these are the three R's. So Plato was also in the opinion that the student must enter in the class at the age of 6 years, and they must be involved in learning the three R, that is a reading, writing and arithmetic. Then they must be engaged in some other, that is the music, sports, physical activities for the proper development of their fine motor skills, together with the developing interest in the music, arts, dance and drama. And when you will further read the Plato, he was in opinion that the dance and music training must be given to the both, means the boy and the girl, men and women must be given the training of dance, drama and the music. And then he talks that at the age of 18 years, they must undergo the military training, and that was the military training compulsory, mandatorily for all. He talked that at the age of 18 years, they must undergo to the military training and the physical training. And at the age of 21 year, they may enter to the higher education. So that was the structure of education as per the Plato is concerned. Then when they will become 30 years, then they will start studying the philosophy, and they will serve the governance. So to be a part of a governance, to be a part of a ruling, so they will study the philosophy and they will become eligible for the governance. And that was for the upper hierarchy in the society. Upper hierarchy, it was not based upon the caste, class or a group. Other thing, it was based upon their competency. As yesterday I was discussing, that those who are primary elementary education was for all, the classification was based upon their competency. Yesterday we were discussing that the elementary education was mandatory, compulsory for all children, and then after that there will be one test, and those who will pass, then they will go for the military training and the physical education, and those who will fail, then they will be categorized as the tradesmen's, laborers, and then again after the completion of the military training, then there will be again test, and those who will pass, they will go for the higher education, and the people who have got the higher education, out of that there will be election, and they will go for the governance, and those who will fail, they will serve as a defense services, police, and the security of the nation. And at the age of 50 years, they will be ready to rule and serve the country. And when we talk about the structure of education proposed by Plato, we found that the education is a lifelong process. It is starting at the age of 6 years when they are entering the elementary school, and it is continuing up to the age of 50-60 years. So it's a lifelong learning. Means throughout the life you have to learn. So it was the, in true spirit, it was a lifelong learning. And even it is opinion by the some of the philosophers that actually the philosophy of education proposed by the Plato was not a pedagogy in nature, rather than it was an andragogy in nature. I think you must be knowing the difference between the pedagogy and the andragogy. These are the two words which is used for the art and science of teaching and learning. Hana, because we know that teaching and learning is a art and science. So it is the art and science. So the art and science of a teaching and learning, which is basically for the children's, that is known as the pedagogy. And the art and science of a teaching and learning that are for the adults, that is the andragogy. And here it is a contextual tutorial, that's why I'm saying, when we talk about the B.Ed and the M.Ed programs, teacher education program and teacher educators program. Here, in fact, we used to teach the pedagogy by the means of andragogy. We are utilizing the andragogy to teach the pedagogy. Isn't it? So, these two terms you must be very clear about that. Pedagogy is the art and science of teaching the children's. Andragogy is the art and science of teaching the adults. This is the only the basic difference between these two terms. Then the further in detail, when we see about the Platonian system of education, then so when you will talk about the Platonian system of education, you will find that the age just after the birth up to the 3 years, they are in the infancy period, and in this period education will be at a home, and the education is the training will be that the body will be growing, sensory organs will be developing, and the child will be start identifying the some of the object. They will start having the feelings of a pleasure and a pain, and that is the very beginning of the child's life. And when they will be in the age group of 4 to 6 years, that is the nursery age, and that time also they will be educated and trained at a home by the means of a play, fairy tales, nursery rhymes, and the get rid of the self will, means the developing the self confidence and all those things. And then when they will become they will come to the age of 6 years, then they will go to the elementary school, wherein the teaching and learning process will be basically by the playway method, the storytelling method, and the emphasis will be on the development of a physical strength, the fine motor skills, and the development of the praising the literary writings like the poetry and other things, developing and praising the singing, dancing, religions, and having the introduction to the numbers and the geometrical figures. These things will be the part of the curriculum. When they will come to the 13 to 16 years, that time is the age of imposing extensively with the literary activities, cultural activities like playing the instrument, singing, dancing, poetry recitation, and all those things. This is the age. And when they will come to the 16 to 20 years, that is the age of mandatory military training and the physical education, whereas the formal gymnastics and the military training will be undergoing. And here in this part, intellectual training will not be there. Intellectual training is that the teaching learning of a content like mathematics, like the science, the language, literature, these things will be not in this period, that is the 16 to 20 years. Then the 20 to 30 years, they will read the science. And remember, this is the higher education stage. That is not for all. Those who will fail at a military training stage, they will be in the military. And those who will pass, only they will go for the science education, isn't it? Wherein they will be developed the reasoning ability and the critical and creative thinking ability. These will be emphasized. And in the age group of 30 to 35 years, here they will be extensively exposed to the philosophy, psychology, sociology, governments, law, and the education, because they are being prepared for the governance, isn't it? And by the 30 to 35 years, when they will be being prepared for the governance, they will serve the state, because in the 30 to 35 years, they were prepared for the service. So 35 to 50 years, they will be serving. And when they will come at the end of 50 years to the life stage of life, end of their life, they will become a philosopher. Philosopher means they will be engaged in the guiding the governance. They will be engaged in the research, policy development, like that work they will be doing. So they will become a philosopher. So these are the proposed structure of education as per the Plato. This is the Platonian system of schools. Okay. Then now when we see about the within this structure, we find that the elementary schools, elementary education was open for all. It was not restricted for the summons, like only boys or only girls. This type of a restriction was not there. Elementary school was open for all. And in fact, we have also discussed earlier that in the view of Plato, women must be given the education. He was in a favor of a women education, and he was treating women equally as a man. So the elementary education will be same, and it will be together. You can understand like a co-education will be up to the elementary level, wherein the boy and girl both will be engaged in learning mathematics, literature, poetry, dance, drama, music up to the age of 18 years. Then after that, they will undergo to the military training, as I was saying. Here, in the military training, the emphasis on to select the best youth who can act as a guardian in the future for the state. Act as a guardian in the future for the state, like that if they will be failed after the military training, then they will be acting as a defense person. So they will be defending their country from the extremist attack. And if they will go for the higher education, then they will be serving the state and they will also act as a philosopher, mentor for the state when they will come at the end of 50 years up to their life. And then after that, there is a concept of a higher education, isn't it? So higher education was only for them who have passed the military training and those who are suitable for the serving the country, those who have the high intellect, that for them only the higher education was there. So that was about the scheme of education as per the Plato. Now when we talk about the teaching method, what kind of a method was there as a method of teaching learning? So when we talk about the elementary level, Plato suggests that a student must be engaged in learning by doing. So learning by doing and playway method was one of the very prominent method of teaching at an elementary level. And the child must be trained in process of a thinking and abstracting. So that was the emphasis at an elementary level. Then Plato also wanted to motivate and develop the interest in the learning among the children. And he was the against of the punishment. That is also very one of the important thing of a Platonian system of education, Platonian philosophy of education. He was against the punishment and he was, sorry. He was in opinion that education cannot be imparted by force. The learning can learned by their self-interest. And he was in opinion, that is a very beautiful quote by the Plato, the knowledge which is acquired under the compulsion obtains no hold on the mind. The knowledge which is gained, that is obtained by the compulsion, obtains no hold on the mind. So that is the rote learning. If it is a learning by compulsion, that is the rote learning. Then according to Plato, he was saying that do not train the student by force or harass them, but direct them by what kind of a modality of a learning they want, or what kind of a pleasure their mind is having. So your mind finds a pleasure in which method, in which work, you must be engaged in that as per the pleasure of your mind. So that was the another beautiful quote by the Plato. He also wanted that there must be a place where the children love to go and stay there, and they play with the things, and by playing with the things they enhance their education and they learn. And Plato has also given the very important place to a nursery education, that is the pre-primary education, which is also a process of school readiness, which is the very much emphasized, and it is a right also by the National Education Policy 2020. When you will see the National Education Policy 2020, the structure of education is restructured, and the first foundation year is of foundation of education is of 5 years, wherein the first 2 years is for the pre-primary education, and then the next 3 year is the class 1, 2, and 3. It is a very rightly emphasized, which was emphasized by the Plato even. So you can think that how much the thought of a Plato, the philosophy of a Plato for the education was a progressive in nature, and it's still it is a very much significant, isn't it? Then when we talk about the higher education, the kind of education, the method of teaching was the dialectic method, which is the Socratic method. In fact, Socratic method, why? Because it is the method of a teaching that was proposed by the Socrates. So that is, it's also known as the Socratic method. And Socratic method is nothing but it's a dialectic method. And in the dialectic method, teacher uses a questions to get the answer from the student, and by means of replying the question, the student will be start thinking, they will be involved in the exploring. So this is the dialectic method. So dialectic method was one of the important method in the Platonic system of education, wherein the teacher was posing the questions and then the student were engaged in the exploring and finding of the answer for the questions. So that was the one of the important method of teaching in the Platonian system of education. Apart from that, the storytelling and the literature was one of the method in the elementary level and the primary level, isn't it? Even when we talk about the discipline as per the Plato, he was in opinion that the self-discipline is important in the teaching learning process, wherein a student should be temperated and a master of himself and ruler of their own pleasure and passion. Means the student will be trained in such a way that they can control on their mind and a feeling and a pleasure to get a quality education. And the discipline is a very much important as per the Platonian philosophy of education. In the Plato view, the child's character will be formed while the child is playing. And one should observe that how they are developing and they are shaping their nature and their character. So teacher here is an observer, here is a mentor in establishing the discipline. But in order to establish a discipline, the student should not be humiliated, they should not be punished like that. We have law in our country about the you cannot humiliate the student. That is the law against the corporal punishment. It is banned in the country. And you can think that even the Platonian system of education was such great in that aspect. It was talking about the corporal punishment at that time, isn't it? So that was the one of the very much important aspect. Then when we talk about the components, that what were the component of subjects in the teaching learning process, you can think about the curriculum. So the curriculum was very scientific, which was balanced from the every aspect. It has a scope of language literature. It was emphasized over the mathematics. There was a component of social science and humanities, like a sociology, like a philosophy, like a psychology. It was balanced with the physical education. It was balanced with the development of the literary sense, the other things. And in the primary level and nursery level, development of a 3R, that is the reading, writing and arithmetic, that was also as per the latest trend, latest research finding that we have nowadays. That was as per that. So in that we can say that the curriculum in the Platonian system was well balanced. When we talk about the objective and function of education as per the Platonian system, because what was the function and what was the objective of education as per the Platonian system of education? The first objective of education as per the Plato was that the unity of the state. And he was in opinion the unity of the state can be guaranteed through the education, and through the education the student must be developed a nationalism, patriotism, and the sense of a feeling and a belongingness for the country, and they must be prepared to serve the country. Like that they had a sorting at a different level of a hierarchy. That hierarchy may be a point of objection, a point of debate, discussion, but the overall aims and objective and goal of the Plato was to prepare the children for serving the nation. Then the next objective of education as per the Plato was to develop the virtue or a civil education, because through the education we were preparing these children for the different work. Those who are not having the high intellect and the physical capacity, they will go for the work, tradesman. Those who have a physical capacity, they will go for the military training. Those who are having the high intellect, they will go for the serving the governance, they will become a philosopher. But all will have a military training. Physical education, basic military training and political education. So that the strength and the efficacy, the civic sense can be guaranteed. Then the next objective was to develop the reasoning, creating thinking and a critical thinking ability among the student. Because these component, mathematics and all those things, component was since the beginning of the education as per the Platonian system of education. The arts, dance, drama, music, literary activities was also part of education. To develop a sense of aesthetic value, aesthetic sensibility. So that was the also one of the important aspect of Platonic system of education, and the important objective of Platonic system of education to develop the aesthetic sensibility. So this was the objective of education as per the Plato. In the Platonic system, already I have discussed that the women education was emphasized and they were treated equally as them. Plato, when you will see in detail, he finds that there is no difference between men and women except the physical structure, and in some case when women is shorter than men and weaker than men. But in some case, he is not generalizing that women are weak, women are short in height. No, he is not generalizing. He believed that men and women are equal and they can perform equal work if they are trained for that. But in some cases, yeah. So he recognized the power of a woman and importance of a woman, and he treats. For that we are struggling since centuries. You think even nowadays we don't treat men and women equally. For sake of saying we can say, but you just see the practices in our family and in our society. Is men and women are same? In the practice, I'm not talking in the practice. not only in the book of law or in the book of something else. No, in the practice, men and women are still not treated equally. Even you will find that women were not allowed to take admission in the Sainik school, which is run by the Ministry of Defense. Do you know? I think most of you may not be knowing. When you will go to the Sainik school, you will not find a girl student in the Sainik school. Means they are thinking that girl students are not suitable for the military training and for the military purpose. Now, one minute. Now, one school, I think in the Kerala or in some part of south of India is opened, which admits the girl student. But that is the single school, Sainik school. We have a Sainik school in Bhubaneswar also. You can go and visit. You won't find any girl student, isn't it? And that is very important aspect of a Platonian system of education. Even when we talk about the role of a teacher, we are struggling for not punishing the student, making the school culture and environment very harmonious. Even we have to make an act for rule for against corporal punishment, but still the incident of a corporal punishment is still seen in the school. Even in that time, Plato was in opinion that there should be no place of corporal punishment, and a school must be an enjoyable place for a student, and a teacher is a torch bearer, their guide, their philosopher, they are a facilitator, which we are talking and struggling to implement in the constructivist era. So you can understand that how his philosophy is important and how his philosophy is progressive in nature. In the last, we will see that we have talked about Plato, that how his thought was progressive. But it is not like that everything was well and good. There was some point of criticism also. The one very important point of a criticism is not understanding the individual difference, because the structure of education was single. If you are able to do, then you will go to the next, otherwise you discontinue. Primary, if you fail, then you cannot go other. After military, if you have failed, then you cannot go. So it was not recognizing the individual difference. He was suggesting a kind of education to be given to an entire class of a people according to the uniform curriculum. Everything was fixed. That is not practical, and that is, you know, that is not good also. He was also against providing the education, higher education, to a productive classes like the laborers, like the tradesmen's. He was against giving the higher education to those productive classes, which is against their right as per the recent conceptualization of the human rights and the education. It is an incident of denying their human rights. Even when we talk about the Platonian system of education, there was a neglect of literacy education, because the Plato curriculum emphasize in the developing the physical education and the fine motor skills, military training, and all those things. It is emphasized, and it neglects training in literature by stressing importance training in literature. And it was, when you will see this whole philosophy, you will find it is, this philosophy is overemphasizing the mathematics and the philosophy. These two things is the overemphasizing, which reduces the scope for the other subjects and disciplines. Philosophy is overemphasized. So these are the point of a criticism where the Plato philosophy is criticized.